What's going on, everyone? My name is Suboptimal, and today is October 31st, and that means it is time for Halloween. For those that don't know, Halloween occurs every year on October 31st, and it's just a time where kids dress up as monsters and get free candy. Halloween has always been my favorite holiday, not because of the candy, but it's just a time where me and my friends would get together, go around trick-or-treating, eat some pizza, play some Call of Duty, or play some Halo. So today I'm going to do something spooktacular and help you guys along the way. Setting up terminal themes is super straightforward, so let's just dive right in. In order to set up themes on your terminal, you're first going to have to get rid of your terminal and download iTerm 2. If you're on Mac, iTerm 2 is just a terminal emulator, and it's just a lot better than Mac. It offers a lot more customizability. So you'll notice that you have a lot more options for customization on iTerm 2. And one of the really important customization features is going to be the themes. All you have to do is basically get the theme and import it into your iTerm. And this is how you can do that with Dracula. Go to any folder that you want. I'm going to just go to documents and run this command. And this command, all it does is it clones this repository, which has the iTerm preset. And when you clone it, if you cd into iTerm, and you'll see that the iTerm colors are right here. So how do you actually import these colors into your iTerm 2? All you do is go to your preferences. You can press command comma to open your preferences, or you can go to your preferences by clicking manually over here. Once you do that, you go to profiles, you go to colors, and then you import the new color theme. So as you can see, I'm in documents, and then I go to iTerm, and basically I have to import this thing into my iTerm 2. I already imported it, so it's saying that it is a duplicate right now, but if you don't have it imported, then it'll import automatically, and then all you do is press Dracula here, and you'll see that now you have the Dracula color theme. Pretty straightforward. There's a lot of other themes that you can do. So yeah, that's gonna be it for today's video. You know, I hope you guys learned how you can change themes on iTerm 2. Let me know what you guys think of the Dracula theme. I personally actually kind of like it. I've always liked Groovebox, but it has been getting a little bit stale since I've been using it for nearly 6 months now, so I think this change of pace is good for me. Plus, it reminds me of Halloween, my favorite holiday all the time, so can't go wrong with that. And yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and if you did, you know, leave a like and subscribe for more in the future. I post new videos every week. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you guys next time.